about what kind of vegan topic you want you that I make an next video about. Or maybe you want to know me perspective on some philosophy that is not 100% vegan maybe, but is also not against veganism. I mean in the context that it's not something that why something that vegan. But for example, you want to know my opinion about certain people on YouTube or in the media. Or maybe you want that I do my research about some medical stuff and I make a video about it so I can explain you more about such stuff. By the way, this is shiitake, avocado, carrot, and eggplant sushi. If you want to know what is in my sushi. In the case of this, your first video, my channel, I am one vegan philosopher and an animal rights philosopher. I am also very interested in history and psychology, and therefore I know a lot about such stuff. I have also a form of autism. I have Asperger's syndrome. So maybe you want that I make a video about that topic and connect it with veganism. By the way, autism is not caused by veganism. Actually, if I'm being honest, actually when you are vegan, you, in my case for example, I've got less problems with my symptoms. It improved it very much, in a very good way. I have less panic attacks, or being less socially awkward. Even, maybe some of you find me still socially awkward, because I don't fit in the social rules of society. I'm not a typical man, and I'm also not a trans person. I'm somewhere in between. I'm also asexual. That means that I don't fall in love with others. I'm asexual and I am aromantic. At least I think I am aromantic, because I have not been fall in love. Asexual means actually that you don't want to have any sexual relation, but maybe you want to have a relation with somebody, but not the sexual intercourse aspect of it. And if you will ask me how long I have been vegan, I am now for, as I say, my vegan journey started around 40 years ago. I was not completely 100% vegan maybe from the endpoint, since I have not all the information I have today. But I started to speak up for rights animals around that time. More. Yes, that's sometimes get me in trouble with my parents, mostly my father. I mean with the trouble, and that's my father. I get always the idea, I don't know if it's true, that he does not understand my position at all. To this day. My mother also not completely, but she is at least vegetarian, and when I eat by her, I dare eat anybody eats a vegan. That's my rule for eating with non-vegans or carnies. If you want to eat with me, you eat vegan. If you are not want, I see you later. I don't have the patience or the sympathy anymore for people who want to eat dismembered corpses in front of my face. Or the secretions of those enslaved living beings. And you'll find that offensive. I ask you, watch it from the victim's point of view. You are not a victim. The animals are. Vegans are the ones who speak up for the victims, and animals are the victims. Think about how you'll feel if the day you were born, somebody else is already planning the day of your execution. Not finally, is it not? So, to it also not to the other animals. The problem with people is that there seems to have so much disconnect with empathy. There seems to not, if they don't being asked to give empathy. This is a bit like sociopaths. Sociopaths also cannot feel true empathy. They can feel something as in psychology they call it something like cold empathy, which is actually acting like you have empathy. It is fake this, so it is not instinctive or come not from the heart. It comes from actually egocentrism. From the ego, from their think I act like I have empathy so I can manipulate others, if you understand what I mean with that. Narcissists and psychopaths are incapable of feeling true compassion. Their act may be sometimes the way, since that can hold them out of trouble, but they're actually in their essence only care about themselves. They are the ultimate egocentrists. Narcissists are not environmentalists, at least if they don't can make money out of it. And yes, it seems to me that it's become harder and harder to diagnose people with narcissistic personality disorder, since it works like a parasite. It infects a complete society. It makes the society themselves also more cruel when those people are in power. More reckless, more profit driven. Not about long term solving problems, but let it seem that it solve a problem, but actually you create more problems for the next generation. But that does not care. But does the narcissist not care about? The narcissist actually cares only about himself. He does not care about his children. He don't care about the next generation. He cares mostly about himself. At least if there is not something as a benefit for himself. So don't be a narcissist. Place yourself in the position of the victim. Just like you are, don't decide the way to respect of a pedophile. Why should you respect people how want to eat other animals? Animals don't want to be food. That's the reason that if you have a watch the slaughterhouse footage, you see always that the animals have fear in their eyes and they want to try to escape. They know what's next. They are not stupid. They are not automatons. They are living sentient beings. Living sentient creatures. How they want to be free, just like me, just like you. So the only logical thing you can do in this situation that is morally just is go vegan. What's the excuse for not going vegan? Apathy? Selfishness? Malice? Malice means corruption, by the way. It means just the purest form of evil. It means viciousness. Quality, I suggest we should not to support, but rather annihilate. You can still eat sushi when you are vegan, so I show you. You can still eat most of your favorite food. There are also very good vegan burgers, by the way, if you want, if your favorite food is hamburgers. Beyond Meat, for example. But there are, you can also make a very good substance from beans, bean burgers. You also have Satan, does have actually the exact same structure as animal flesh, most particular beef and cow flesh. So, stop making excuses. About world hunger. We can easily stop world hunger if anybody will come here. The average vegan takes just 1/6 of an acre of land, in contrary with the average Western carnivore, non-vegan, takes around 3 acres of land. By my calculations, when they're eat grass feed, and it is even higher, or suggest some eight to nine, dependent on which statics you use. I hope we can agree that it is unfair to ask for something you are not willing to give. So, you think it is unfair to ask to expect mercy when you are a mass murderer? Do we agree?
Oh.
I hope we also can agree that killing is evil and cruelty is evil. It takes less than the half of the world to feed a million on plant-based diets. But it takes around 6 plants to feed anybody on a Western, specifically American style diet. It's ecological insane. It is also cruel to the animals. It is an environmental death disaster, the biggest Holocaust ever. Now people, if people know my channel and watch a couple of my videos, maybe now know that Holocaust means in old Greeks the sacrificing of a male animal on the altar of God. So why can it be used to refer to the execution of slaughter Jews, but not to the even far greater number of animals who are executed any year. $12 million versus $70 billion. $70 billion land animals and 2.8 trillion marine animals. Please, stand for a moment by these estimates before you react angry to me. If we will kill members of our own species in the same rate that we kill the other animals, we will have decimated our species in less than 70 days. Like William Innes once said, in a 19th century setting, we have treated our cousins in fur and feather so horribly that without a doubt, if there ever will form an organized religion, they will take the devil in our form. That statement break my heart the day I wrote it for the first time. It still breaks my heart today. Because they must look to us as devils. They must think we are totally pure and malicious. We are stealing their babies. We're stealing their babies' food. We throw newborn male chickens in a rendering machine. We execute them in unscientific vivisection experiments. We grow organs of pig organs, of hominid organs, inside of pigs. Xenotransplantation. Sick, twisted, psychotic. I'm not proud to belong to this. Sarcasm of a species. I'm embarrassed. To ever once been proud to belong to such a shameful species. I'm saying this not to be mean. I know what lions do, so don't come up with that shit. I know what some other animals do, but it comes not even close to the amount of terror we inflict onto the other animals. So, stop throwing stones in somebody's glass house. And learn something. From somebody I called you out. Somebody who is not a politician. Somebody who don't respect people's opinion just because they belong to my species. I'm not a charlatan. I'm not a liberal. I'm not a Republican. I'm not a socialist. An anthropocentric socialist. I'm not a capitalist in any way. I am a biocentrist philosopher. I watch the oppositions from the Earth's perspective and don't take my own species as a favorite. I'm not a bigot. I'm not an anthropocentric speciesistic bigot. I'm an earthling first and foremost, and as such, I take any position, I support the earth as one whole. Even if that means that I have to betray my own species, my own species' interests. And if you then say that I'm a traitor to my own species, now, guys and girls, I'm a proud traitor to a sick, twisted, psychotic house guest who have refused to live in harmony with the three laws of ecology. And if you then claim that I'm a terrorist, you know, the Dalai Lama was a terrorist, according to the Chinese government. That word is so much overused in bad contexts that it have totally lost his true potential, his true essence. Today, it is nothing more than a public relation shit artist's word to blame anybody who you don't like, when it in fact is the act of bringing terror onto other living beings. What they're doing, the animal holocaust and of our culture, if you want that I call them now, is nothing less than terror on mass scale. It comes not even close to the amount of terror and mayhem ISIS brings. And don't understand me wrong. I say not ISIS is a good organization. I say there are also a very bad organization, but animal agriculture is, in my opinion, far lot worse than that organization. Because animal agriculture is the reason for world hunger, it is the most biggest environmental threat on the planet. 51%, I consider it a conservative estimate, because there are higher numbers. Of all the greenhouse gas emissions coming from animal agriculture, it is unfair to ask for something you are not willing to give. That's the definition of injustice. Since you don't want to be treated the way a pig to be treated, is treated in animal agriculture, put in a mat between two metal bars, where she not can move, and castrated without anesthesia. And then the tears being cut off, and the ears are clipped. Their children are being stolen, also a part of the definition of the FBI for terrorism. Animal rights activists are not terrorists. The farmers are the terrorists. They are hurting the animals. They are sending those animals to slaughter, execution, and mass murder. This is a place of a slaughter. And Hitler designed the concentration camp on the idea of animal agriculture. So why in hell's name want you to defend the thing that have inspired the Holocaust when you are so much against it? Animal agriculture must be disappeared. It is an unjust organization. It does not have any place in the 19th century. Must always some small group of enlightened folk to explain to the masses why murder, rape, torment, exploitation, and kidnapping are wrong, unjust, and evil. It will be for once fine if anybody understands justice and equality without discussing it and debating it for 100 or 1,000 decades of time to obtain the abyss, evolve, and go vegan.